Welcome back to The Race. I'm Chris Stewart, this week in Wheeling, West Virginia, and we're taking a look at the future of government benefits. Now, for Americans serving in the military, they can face many challenges both during and after their service. Alicia Nieves is taking a look at the government program set up designed to help.
In Jacksonville, Florida, Robert Bannon runs a small business coaching and training golfers, both professionals and beginners.
And we can look at the charts to see how stable that club is.
I always had the vision in my mind that I wanted to do something like this, but I wasn't sure how it was going to work. And that was the hard part.
Figuring that out became easier, in part thanks to a government benefit.
My benefit was post-9/11 GI Bill.
Bannon spent more than two decades in the Army. He served in Operation Desert Shield and Desert Storm, then as part of the Joint Staff in the Pentagon during 9/11. After, he committed to going to the Middle East doing two tours in Iraq. The post-9/11 GI Bill, when he returned home, paid his tuition and part of his housing at the College of Golf at Kaiser University.
The schooling helped me not only on the technical side on how to teach and how to learn more about the golf swing, but the business of golf was a heavy influence in there.
The money he saved on tuition, he put into the business, built the facility for TPG Golf, and essentially, the GI Bill helped him build a new future post-service. Over the past 75 years since the first version of the GI Bill was passed, it has helped more than 18 million veterans do the same.
The burden that we place on them mentally, how much we stress them in combat and what we ask of them, and the risks that they take. I think what we do for them when they come home is a small price that the entire country pays. It just takes a special individual, you know, to get up every morning and, you know, walk out the door and leave their family and really not know what's on the other side. It's just incredibly important, you know, that we look after all of our, you know, military when they get back and try to give them the support they need.
And although well earned by him and many others, he is grateful to have gotten that support through the GI Bill. For The Race, I'm Alicia Nieves.
And that'll do it for us this week for a conversation about government benefits in America. Join us next week as we take a look at education, the discussion about school choice, and the new ways kids are learning. Until then, from Wheeling, West Virginia, I'm Chris Stewart, and this is The Race.